Whew, okay. Kyle, of all the people you've met on your journey, and of all the places you've been, somehow, some way, by the grace of God, you found me. 5 years ago, you asked me, I believe we could take on the world. What do you say? I told you I'd love to take on the world with you. I still have that same answer. Without hesitation, today I give myself to you. The love that we share is once in a lifetime. You are my soulmate, best friend, and today you'll become my husband. Our relationship has been tested, yet we always come back stronger together. I know that whatever gets thrown our way in life, you'll stand by my side, put me first, and love me unconditionally through it all. You're the most amazing, handsome, loyal, hardworking, selfless man I know. And even though you can be a smartass sometimes, I still love you with all of my heart. You've brought so much happiness and joy into my life, and I cannot be more proud to become your wife today, and I'm so excited for this next chapter. And I thank God every day that we get to spend the rest of our lives together. I vow to stand with you when the struggles of life hold us down and celebrate you when life brings us joy. I vow to remain faithful and honor you as your wife. I vow to be the best mother I can be to our children one day. I vow to always stand by your side in sickness and in health. I vow to love you unconditionally and tell you that I love you every day. I vow to always put you first. And I vow to choose you today, tomorrow, and for the rest of my life. I love you higher than the sky. Oh, God. Can I say a prayer real quick? Can you grab my hand? Lord, thank you for binding us together as one. Please remind our hearts each day of the love we share. We ask that you be the center and anchor of our marriage. Guide us and bless us. Help us love each other as you love us with gentleness and patience. Amen. Oh.
So definitely, babe, our vows are different. I was kind of curious as to how ours were going to go, but in a good way. They're different. I wrote, Alex, you are the love of my life and best friend. I'm so thankful to spend the rest of my life with you. Ever since the first time we spent together, I felt something touch my heart sincerely that I knew right off the bat you were a kind-hearted person. And that day, you were very gorgeous and down to earth, bringing light around you and the environment. That you really, it really made you stand out. In that moment, I knew you were my soulmate, best friend. We clicked like we already knew everything about each other. I love that you have taken care of me in so many ways I can't explain that I'm grateful for. I love you for making me feel like I'm wanted when we are together, to where I miss you for that when we are apart. We have grown so much together over a handful of years. You inspire me to be a better person. I love you. I love when you try to hold my hand, kiss me goodnight, and we kiss good morning. I remember us being together at the house down the road from Dad's, bonding together, constantly holding hands. we're playing beer pong, even though you were bad.
I am not bad at beer pong.
Just kidding. We kicked ass that night. But in all seriousness, another time at the fireworks stand, you know, when we were really actually hanging out, you met everybody and you were so pretty that day, and I enjoyed the time we spent and stepping back and just smiling at you because I was happy that you looked happy. And by the way, I still have that photo of that day. So I promise to love you and be by your side through ups and downs. I vow to be the partner you deserve and always giving the best advice. I promise to love you and support you. I vow to always be faithful and be your best friend no matter what the future brings. I promise to spend the rest of our days loving you madly. I promise to take care of you and prioritize your needs when you need it. I promise to not get caught up in petty arguments. I promise you my heart, and with it, I'm forever yours. These vows will stand true. You have me completely. You are the love of my life, and I respect you for the rest of our days. I will respect you for the rest of our days, and I will be here through thick and thin, babe. Love you. Yeah, that's it. I'm good. Wow, that's hard. That is hard. But I'm glad we did it right now instead of later, because.
No, I know.
Holy shit, man. Yeah. It'd either be a mixture of sweat and tears or just both. But I love you, babe.
I'm sorry.
My, oh my. Oh, it's on.
Come on, out.
Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome, everyone. We come together today in this beautiful setting to celebrate and witness as we join the lives of Kyle and Alexandra. We come together as a unified community of family, friends, and loved ones to wish Kyle and Alexandra a long and happy life together from this day forward. Thank you all for gathering here to witness their marriage and to share in this singular occasion. May we all be fully present during our time together. And in that spirit, Kyle and Alexandra want you to know the greatest gift you can be, give, is to be fully present. So take this opportunity, please, to silence those phones and enjoy this special moment in the moment with us. Now, I have had the pleasure of making acquaintance with many of you before assembling here. And for those of you who are friends I haven't met yet, my name is Sean. And in addition to the honor of officiating here in Texas, I, along with my wife, Rochelle, enjoy the shared blessing of seeing our goddaughter be married today. So thank you very much for your kind attention. And let's light this candle.
Right and left. I was kind of worried if you were going to forget about that. What did y'all do today?
Drink.
Oh, did y'all really? Y'all drank up through all those Trulies?
Not going to lie.
Did y'all really?
Huh?
So that's why I had to buy more?
Yeah.
Travel around the world as a picture.
Hey.
Love you. Love you.
Taco truck is here. Everything's gonna be okay.
Everything's gonna be just fine. That's one thing everybody needs to look forward to, right? Tacos.
I love all food as long as it's Mexican.
Right? Look at those girls. Oh, she's crying. Where do they need to go from there, kid?
Yeah.
You're making me cry.
Please be seated.
Very breathing.
Who gives this bribe?
My beautiful wife, Lisa, and I do.
And accordingly, Kyle and Alexandra wish to take a moment to especially thank their parents for everything they have done for them. Not only for everything they've done to make this day possible, but for being their parents and providing the love and support needed to become the fine people they truly are. I'm sure I speak for all of us when I say what a thrill it is to see you both standing here. Your love and care for one another is evident to everyone around you. Your relationship is such a beautiful balance of hand in hand togetherness, as well as strong support for each other's independence. This affinity brought richness to your relationship, and it has prepared you for this new chapter starting now. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this joyous day. Thank you for your light that has entered Alexandra's and Kyle's life. Thank you for all the miracles and blessings. And Father, please bless this union. Help Alexandra and Kyle find the perfect place in this world for their love to flourish. Let the radiant light of their love shine on all those around them. May all their future creations be blessed. Father, bless them with the inner gifts of trust, compassion, forgiveness, and truth, that they may live and grow together in love and peace. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here to bear witness to one of life's greatest moments. Kyle, Alexandra, for all the great significance of all that is said and done here, this ceremony will not create a relationship that does not already exist between you. Rather, it is a symbol for how far you both have come these past 5 years. No matter the challenges you face them together. No matter how much you succeed together. The love between you joins you as one. So let us begin. You're already facing one another. This will work out great.
Awesome.
And take hold of each other's hands. There you go. Kyle and Alexandra, soon you will seal the eternal bond between you with an exchange of rings and a promise of forever. While these are the hands that will bear those rings, they should always remind you that these are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love one another today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside you as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch, comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you during times of fear or grief. These are the hands that will wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you hold your family together as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it most. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you that same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Kyle and Alexandra, on this day, you not only marry the right person, you also commit to being the right partner, the one with whom the other can stand and face the world. You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. Kyle, from the moment you asked the question, Alexandra, from the time you said yes to this moment of yes, you and Kyle have been making commitments in an informal way. All those conversations that were held in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those conversations that began with, "When we're married," and "You will," and "We will," all those late night talks that included "someday" and "somehow" and "maybe," all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart, all these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, "Remember all those things that we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word." Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another: acquaintance, friend, companion, dancing partner, even teacher, for you have learned much from one another these past years. Shortly, you shall say a few words that will take you across a threshold of life and into a new and sacred togetherness. For after today, you shall say to the world, "This is my husband. This is my wife." Kevin, will you please bring forth the rings?
I need your ring.
Well, he's gonna give it back to you.
Oh, okay, not bad.
Buckle up. Kyle, please place the ring on Alexandra's finger. please repeat after me? Alexandra, I give you this ring.
Alexandra, I give you this ring.
As a reminder.
As a reminder.
That I will love, honor, and cherish you.
As I will love, honor, and cherish you.
In all times.
In all times.
In all places.
In all places.
And in every way.
In every way.
Forever.
Forever.
It is a symbol.
It is a symbol.
Of my eternal love.
Of my eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise.
And the promise.
Of all my tomorrows.
Of all my tomorrows.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I bind my life to yours.
I bind my life to yours.
Alexandra, place the ring on Kyle's finger.
Been waiting on that one, huh?
I have been for a very long time.
Yeah, it still fits. That's good. Alexandra, please repeat after me. Kyle, I give you this ring.
Kyle, I give you this ring.
As a reminder.
As a reminder.
That I will love, honor, and cherish you.
That I will love, honor, and cherish you.
In all times.
In all times.
In all places.
In all places.
And in every way forever.
And in every way forever.
It is a symbol.
It is a symbol.
Of my eternal love.
Of my eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise.
And the promise.
Of all my tomorrows.
Of all of my tomorrows.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I bind my life to yours.
I bind my life to yours.
Kyle and Alexandra, we have heard your promise to share your lives in marriage. And in the honesty and sincerity of what you have said and done here today, and by the power vested in me by the County of Hunt and the great state of Texas, it is now my greatest pleasure to declare you to be husband and wife. Kyle, you may kiss your bride.
Are you gonna play it?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my esteemed honor to present to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Kyle and Alexandra Carney.
Get in there. So first of all, on behalf of
my beautiful and wonderful wife, Lisa. We would like to thank everybody that was able to attend this wedding and congratulate, you know, Kyle and Alex on their nuptials, which I will discuss further later. The first thing I'd like to do is welcome Kyle's family into ours. Kyle has been a very important part of our life since we've met him, we've known him, we vacationed together, we've done a lot of things together, and there's a reason for that. It's how he was raised. It's from the family he was from, and it aligns with our values, and most certainly the rest of my family's values as well. Every one of you here with us today are very special to us for a bunch of different reasons. Especially those who traveled from far distances. And I think Kristen Wallace in Syracuse and maybe Chandra in Washington, D.C. got the record. Or maybe Idaho, Northern Idaho. But I think Kristen Wallace takes the cake on that. So thank you very much for the traveling. I appreciate it. I'd also like to recognize those who could not be here with us today, either because they were sick, elderly, and I pray to the good Lord that he watches over them and continues to watch over those who are no longer with us. I'd also like to recognize the wedding party for taking the time to be part of this special day. It meant a lot to us, and it obviously meant a lot to Alex and Kyle. And for those of all those of you that helped set up, we couldn't have done it without you. I'd also like to recognize one of my best friends since I was probably 5 years old, who gave prayer before the dinner tonight, and that's. That's Cody Sewell. Before I go there, can I get a hand of the first responders in this room tonight? Law enforcement, firefighters. Well, raise your hand. Raise your hand if you're a firefighter. If you're a firefighter, law enforcement, nurse, first responder. Raise your hand. And retired. Roger, raise your hand. Julie, raise your hand. Now, anyone who's a firefighter, keep your hand up. Yes, so that's been our relationship for the last 30 years. And also, Constable Cody, thank you for being here with us tonight, keeping us safe and watching over us. God bless you. And I'd also like to pay special tribute to the following people who really made this special day happen. To my beautiful wife, Lisa, who put so much work into this day from day one. One of my best friends, Sean Falwell, the officiant, and his wife, Rochelle, who's with us tonight as well. Following his speech is, man, I tell you, that's a tough one. Of course, Nicole Schumann, Sergeant Schumann, and where's Heather at? Heather Bruin, where you at? Heather Bruin as well. They both played a huge role and instrumental role in helping coordinate this wedding. I'd also like to recognize Dana Dietrich and her husband Mark for the flowers. And the ceremony set up, and just about everything like thing else that came along with it. We couldn't not have done it without them. I'd like to recognize Melissa, my daughter, the maid of honor. Kevin, who's the best man, and Colby, who also organized and was instrumental in the bachelor party. I'd also like to recognize Kyle's parents, Ron Carney, and his significant other, Melissa, who hosted a wonderful, wonderful dinner after our rehearsal last night. I'd also like to recognize Katie, who helped organize and put together the bachelorette bachelorette party for Alex. And Kyle's parents, back to Kyle's parents, Ron and his significant other, Melissa. My mother, Linda Chudel, my father, Mike, who could not be with us tonight. Also, Lisa's mother, Darla, who could also not make this trip either. And I wasn't going to really say anything anecdotal about Alex, but I will. I knew from day one, when she was about 2 or 3 years old, that she was a determined, established, on the right track, not too judgmental, but knew what she wanted in being determined in life. And I found that out when our second daughter, Melissa, was born. Well, we went to the hospital, and Alex showed up to see Melissa and, say hi and everything else. And so she holds Melissa, and she holds her, and kisses her. She goes, "Okay, now, Mommy, put her back in. We're leaving now. Bye." So, Kyle, good luck with that. And one last anecdote. For some of those that don't know, I recently got hearing aids, and I've had selective hearing for about
26 years.
I hope you don't have to ever get hearing aids, Kyle. But if you do, just remember that is a real medical term, selective hearing. So, with that said, if everyone could grab their glass of whatever they wish to drink. And by the way, if I miss anybody else on this list that helped tonight, thank you very much. We could not have done it without you. So to Alex and Kyle, to a wonderful relationship, congratulations.
Next up, we have the maid of honor, Miss Melissa Williams. Let's give her a big round of applause.
Here, please.
How about it?
He's sad.
Alex, you do everything for the photo op.
I do.
Wait till you hear this bad boy.
Oh,
I'm gonna knock it out the ball. That's loud. All right, so I've been planning this speech for quite some time now, and I couldn't find the right words to say, so I went somewhere sacred and somewhere I could find some relief, and here it is. Good evening, everyone. I want to thank all of you for coming and celebrating this beautiful new marriage, especially all those who had to buy a plane ticket and take off work to be here. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Melissa, and I am the little sister of the stunning bride tonight. Alex had the honor of meeting me in 1999, and she's been blessed ever since then. Of course we fought, but my memories are filled with laughter, love, and lots of secrets. Alex and I have always had such a tight bond, and that is something I will always cherish. She has always been my protector, except when it was from her. She's always looked after me besides the time when we were younger, and you made me go number two outside and threw me under the bus to death. There has been countless of times Alex has saved me from furthering myself into trouble. When we were younger, Alex was always the trusted sibling. My parents knew that she would always look after my delinquent self. One memory I vividly remember with Alex was one night we were going out and had to obviously come up with a plan on how to get out of the house without my dad exactly knowing where we were going. Alex told me to not say a word to my dad, and she would do all the talking because I cannot lie. And sure enough, because of Alex, I didn't get in trouble that one night. If you have the privilege of knowing my older sister, Alex, you are extremely lucky. Not so lucky if you have been in the car with her, especially after her 7 car accidents, but who's counting? Alex may be a great driver, or sorry, may be a great person, but definitely not a great driver. In fact, it's been years since I've been in the car with Alex due to my PTSD and her car paint. Her car paint still located on the wall of 140 Duncan Street, Walnut Creek, California. Alex is kind, loyal, smart, beautiful, and caring. Alex is an old soul, and that is always a trait I've admired about her. I couldn't live without you, Alex. You make me a better person and always somehow give me the strength I need. Gosh. Okay. I will always...
Come on, baby.
Okay. Always look up to you and listen to your input. I've always felt a weight lifted off my shoulder knowing I had you as an older sister to protect me. I admire how strong, independent, caring, loyal, beautiful, and protective you are. You are one of the hardest workers I know. Throughout every hardship in my life, you have always been there for me and supported me in any way you could. You are an incredible older sister, and I am so grateful that God chose me to be your little sister. I could never thank you enough for all the things you have done for me, but just know it never goes unnoticed. This is so long. Hold on. Okay. You were a great role model and someone I will always desire to be like. I remember when I first met Kyle. It was Alex's graduation, and I had the honor of doing the most typical Texas thing. Going to Sonic. I'm so happy Kyle is joining our family. You picked a good one, Alex. Just like the boogers used to eat when we were little and loved how salty they tasted. I love what he does for you and our family. It is very obvious he loves you so much. He is one of a kind. Very respectful and obvious and loves hard. You guys are just alike. Kyle, I cannot wait to have you as an older brother. Please know that Kyle had to get the approval of not only our mom and dad, but the approval of Sophia and myself. As Alex's little sisters, we are fortunate to know he will always have our backs and look out for us, and that he will have a say in our future suitors.
Amen.
Not Colby. I wish you both many years of health, love, and happiness. I'm so thankful for you guys and cannot wait to watch your relationship grow. Just don't ever forget about me, because it will always be about me.
I got it.
You know that. Both of you are such good people and deserving of each other's love and an inspiration to all of us. I have an incredible sister already, and I've been blessed this evening by gaining a brother too. Alex, Kyle, I hope you know how much I both love and adore you so much. The end.
I love you so much. And you give me some different boogers.
I always have your
boogers. Oh my God.
I always.
And now we have extra toilet paper for the next.
Hey, you not remember COVID? That's such a waste.
All right.
You want to use that, bro?
Huh?
Yeah.
Thank you.
For
my ass. It's all right. We brought it.
All right, back up.
Hi, everybody. How's everybody doing tonight? My name is Kevin Carney. I'm the oldest to Kyle and to Caitlin. This lovely couple here has been a wonderful pleasure to have in our lives for the last 5 years. I've enjoyed them as much as well as everybody else in this room has. I think they've had some amazing friendships, family, as well as somebody who's traveled to enjoy their evening with them tonight. So with that, I'll start my speech. Kyle, you are not my best friend anymore. We were best friends. After you were born, we were inseparable. Kind of like many Lego kits we put together, except they ended up in a million pieces. We did everything together. Climbed trees, acted our favorite shows, some injuries may have been involved, and played sports together as well. Many of which included our own friends accompanying us during these journeys. One of which might have been hitting golf balls on top of a barbed wire fence. Then life began to change. I got a little older. You got annoying. and with a more annoying sidekick, Katie. You were over there. You're everywhere. I love you. So then you gained a new best friend, along with some others. While I was flirting with girls, you were flipping skateboards and being mischievous with Steven and Colby. Life continues on, and your sidekick now becomes more annoying to you, as well as you had gotten older as well. The parents annoy you, and you would call me. And of course, I would agree with Mom and Dad, who was always right. Lead Carney rule, lead Carney rule, remember. You had your best buddies, Steven and Colby, with some new ones, Jake, Dylan, and Sid, who had your back through some tough times. Dad's accident and recovery. You living on your own. And separation of our family. Then you found somebody willing to be your new best friend. She was sweet, kind, and a little shy. But she filled your life with love and joy. And gave you someone other than yourself to care about. I'm talking about everyone's favorite, Dixie. Yeah. Well, she was there first, but no, I mean another lady of love in your life, Miss Alex, and now Miss Alex Carney. Alex, you've signed on the line now and said I do, so there's no take backs. He's yours. He's stubborn and can be a giant pain in the ass, but he can also be very caring, loving, just as his Grandpa Willard was before him, who he admires so much. Kyle, Alex is a wonderful lady. She's sweet, kind, and loving. And most of all, she puts up with you and the crap in your mouth. I want to let y'all know, love is finite, but it can last forever. It just takes providing some hard work and elbow grease along the way. Always keep an attentive ear and promise to listen whenever each other speaks. And promise not to go to bed angry. Kyle, you accepted to be my best man, as I have done for you. We still call and check on each other every week. Always say I love you before we hang up, as real men do. Kyle, you are not my best friend. You are my brother. There's no end to that statement. Lastly, you have now married your best friend. From having siblings to buddies, and now your best, and now your wife. I love you both. Congratulations to the groom and bride. Oh, Ms. Carney and Mr. Carney.
Let's hear it one more time, once again, for Kyle and Alexander Carney.